In this video, I will demonstrate how simulation can be applied to mimic stock movements. Suppose you have invested equally in each of the following stocks, and the returns of these four stocks are plotted on the bottom. We also assume returns are normally distributed. Several questions for us to consider regarding the return and volatility of the portfolio. This problem appears to be rather straightforward as we learned about risk normal function to generate values that are normally distributed with some mean and standard deviation. However, in practice, a lot of times stocks, especially those from the same business sector, such as Walmart and Target, tend to move up and down in a similar fashion. Some other stocks may move in the opposite direction. This is indeed the case for stocks 1 and 2. We collected the returns of these two stocks from the last year. Their means and standard deviations are given in the table. The average return of stock 1 is 15%, while that for stock 2 is 10%. Stock 1 has a higher risk than stock 2, as measured by the standard deviation. The returns of both stocks have bell-shaped distributions. The correlation between the two stocks is 0.8, 80%, suggesting that both stocks are highly positively correlated and move in the same direction. When the return of one stock is high, we expect the return of the other stock to be high as well. Let's start off by simulating these two stocks using risk normal function that we learned earlier. The arguments of risk normal can be found in cells B3, C3, B4, and C4 respectively. But the scatter plots of these two stocks does not appear to be correlated at all. You may remember that this is called independent from previous videos. We would have to change our simulation setup to allow a highly positive correlation between the two stocks. This can be accomplished using risk called MAT function, which can be added into our standard risk normal function as its third argument. The risk called MAT function itself has two arguments. The first argument specifies the location of the correlation matrix. In this example, the correlation matrix is located from cell F3 to cell G4. The second argument indicates which column of the correlation matrix should be used. For stock 1, we enter 1 here because the first column of the correlation matrix contains information for stock 1. For stock 2, we would use 2 here because it is the second column of the correlation matrix that contains information for stock 2. After including risk call MAT function in risk normal, the simulated returns have this kind of relationship we would like to see. When the return of stock 1 is high, stock 2 return tends to be high as well. After learning about risk call MAT, we can revisit the questions. Suppose that we have the past return data on these four stocks, including their means, their standard deviations, and their correlations. If we invest equally in these stocks, what is the expected return of the portfolio? How risky is the portfolio? And what is the chance that the return of this portfolio exceeds 20%? For this simulation, the probabilistic inputs are just the returns of these stocks, which we will use risk call MAT to generate. Please pause this video and examine the arguments in the risk normal and the risk call MAT functions. Once we have the individual stock returns, the returns of the portfolio can be easily computed using the average of those four stocks. This is because we invest equally in all stocks. Over here, you could use the summation to compute it. Alternatively, you can use sum product Excel function to calculate it. After the model is set up, we can proceed with the simulation using at risk. to compare the portfolio returns when the correlation is considered versus when the correlation is not considered, I'm going to perform two separate simulations. We can do this easily using iRisk by defining two cells as the outputs of interest. We select both cells C16 and B16 and define both of the portfolio returns as output cells. At risk, we'll keep track of the values in these cells. I set the number of iterations to 1,000 and number of simulations to 1, meaning that the model will run 1,000 times, generating 1,000 returns for each portfolio. Now we click on Simulate and wait for the results from the two different scenarios. To see the results from portfolio with correlation, we can click on cell B16 and this graph will pop up. And to see the results from the portfolio without the correlation, we can click on cell C16 and these results will pop up. We can also overlay both simulation results in one graph by clicking on the overlay button on the very bottom. Let's take a look at the summary statistics. Both portfolios, with and without a correlation, have the same average return of 16.5%. But the portfolio with correlation has a larger standard deviation of 20.28%, whereas the portfolio without a correlation has a standard deviation of 12.59%. The portfolio with correlation also has a higher chance of getting negative returns. It's worth mentioning that the portfolio with correlation is not a diversified portfolio. The four stocks tend to move in the same direction due to their higher positive correlation. To minimize risks while maintaining the average return of the portfolio, we should try to have a diversified portfolio. That would be the portfolio without a correlation. In this example, we learned how to use iRisk functions to incorporate correlation structures in the simulation. This also concludes this video.